Nobody can hear me, can they? Can you hear me? Barely. How about now? Okay. Welcome, Solomon's Porch, Wednesday midweek. God put on my heart to make this a special day. Not that every day is a special, but he wanted to do something special. And, well, first, I just want you to bear with me because in my head, my thoughts are like the lottery balls that you see. They're all jumbling around. There's 30-some of them out there, up there. But only 6 of them can come out, and you never know which one's going to come out. So if it doesn't make sense, at the end, it might, you might have to piece it together and go, that kind of makes a little bit of sense. But what he put on my heart was he was talking to me about chains. And I know we've talked about breaking the chains before, and we have the song, Break Every Chain. But what he showed me was there's different kind of chains that are holding different kind of people. There's the kind of chains that you're bound and you need to break free from that. There's a kind of chain that he showed me you're anchored to the ground with. And the kind of chain, the third one he showed me that he really wants to concentrate on tonight and break people free from, probably me especially, is a chain that's holding us to our past. There's stuff back we're chained to, and for some reason, we want to drag it with us. No matter how hard it is to drag, we will. We'll keep dragging it, and it's tearing everything up, and it hurts to drag that. Believe it, it hurts. But we're dead set on dragging that with us every place we go. So tonight, he told me that's what he wants to concentrate on, is breaking those chains from our past that we, for some reason, want to drag with us. And when you got something that you're chained to that you're trying to drag, guess what? You can't move forward. You can't a little bit, but you can't move forward as much as he wants you to move forward, as fast and accelerated as he wants you to move. You just can't do it because that chain is just too heavy on you. So tonight, I want to pray that we can break any chains that anybody has on them that's holding them back. That I just see them snapping and popping and flying away, and that garbage is left there, that junk is left there, those weights are left there. And tonight is a renewing night and an acceleration night. When those chains get broke, buckle up, because you're going to accelerate in your path, in your walk with him, which you can't do when you're dragging that. So I just pray that over everybody here and online that we break those chains tonight. In Jesus' name.
sing it one more time, dude. How great.
How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. Oh, see how great. How great is our God.
Psalm 145, the Passion Translation. My heart explodes with praise to you. Now and forever my heart bows in worship to you, my King and my God. Every day I will lift up my praise to your name with praises that will last throughout eternity. Lord, you are great and worthy of the highest praise. For there is no end to the discovery of the greatness that surrounds you. Generation after generation will declare more of your greatness and declare more of your glory. Your magnificent splendor and the miracles of your majesty are my constant meditation. Your awe-inspiring acts of power have everyone talking. I'm telling people everywhere about your excellent greatness. Our hearts bubble up and bubble over as we celebrate the fame of your marvelous beauty, bringing bliss to our hearts. We shout with ecstatic joy over your breakthrough for us. You're kind and tender-hearted to those who don't deserve it and very patient with people who fail you. Your love is like a flooding river, overflowing its banks with kindness. God, everyone sees your goodness, for your tender love is blended into everything you do. Everything you have made will praise you, fulfilling its purpose. And all your godly ones will be found bowing before you. They will tell the world of the lavish splendor of your kingdom and preach about your limitless power. They will demonstrate for all to see your miracles of might and reveal the glorious majesty of your kingdom. You are the Lord who reigns over your never-ending kingdom through all the ages of time and eternity. You are faithful to fulfill every promise you've made. You manifest yourself as kindness in all you do. Weak and feeble ones, you will sustain. Those bent over with burdens of shame, you will lift up. You have captured our attention, and the eyes of all look to you. You give what they hunger for just at the right time. When you open your generous hand, it's full of blessings, satisfying the longings of every living thing. You are fair and righteous in everything you do, and your love is wrapped into all your works. You draw near to those who call out to you, listening closely, especially when their hearts are true. Every godly one receives even more than what they ask for. For you hear what their hearts really long for, and you bring them your saving strength. God, you watch carefully over all your devoted lovers like a bodyguard, but you will destroy the ungodly. I will praise you, Lord. Let everyone everywhere join me in praising the beautiful Lord of holiness from now through eternity. So though that was David's prayer a very long time ago, it rings true through the ages and at this moment. It's a prayer of praise and thanksgiving, but also a prayer of encouragement in what we are supposed to do. We're not supposed to take all this goodness and all this great stuff and just hold it within. Yeah, there's a personal purpose for it, but there's an external purpose for this world. So Father, right now, I just pray that as we praise you and as we give you thanksgiving and as we lift you up tonight and every day, Father, that we would be more open to seeing those opportunities to share your love with others, to share your goodness with others, and not just keep it hidden under a basket somewhere, Father. We just thank you for all that you have done and all that you'll continue to do and all that you'll do in the years to come and in our family and, you know, generations and generations to come, Father. We just can't stop praising you. I mean, we could pray 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and never praise you enough, Father, and never thank you enough. Father, we pray for activation, bold activation.
Sing open the eyes.
That's all I can say. I saw a whole bunch of stuff. I'll tell you. I saw angels through here just with these big axes, like just chopping those chains off, and they were flying everywhere. It was awesome. And then he showed me something for you. And I wrote it down because, you know, lottery balls. All right. So, what he showed me is right now he is molding you. He did show me your heart was as bright as that light that he's put inside of you. And he's molding you as, like with clay, when when you mold something with clay, when it starts out, it's not really recognizable because it's a lump, and it's being molded and shaped. But as the artist continues to mold it, you can start to see the shape come through. Then you all of a sudden it's like, oh wow, that's nice. And then they keep working it, depending on the artist. And the artist in this case is God. When they are done, it is one beautiful thing. And he wanted to tell me that's what he is doing in you right now. So if there's something you don't recognize as being molded, just hang in there, because it's going to be beautiful, and it's going to be something you're not going to recognize when it's done. So I just wanted to share that with you. And for the two girls, what he showed me was when you go, stop. When you go on your trip there, I forget what it's called, but that's okay. He showed me while you're down there, he's assembling rockets on your back. All right? And when you leave, that's when the fuse is going to be lit. When you guys get back, I'm warning everybody, stay out of their way, because they're going to take off. And he showed me this. It was crazy. The acceleration in your path and your walk when you get back, it's going to be nuts. So make sure you people see them before they leave, because they are not going to be the same when they come back, and you'll get run over. I'm just gonna say that you will get run over. So I just want to close tonight. Father, we want to thank you for everything you did here tonight and everything you keep doing, working through us, working with us, having great patience with us, that we may see your will and do your will. And Father, we just want to thank you again that we live in a country where we can get together and worship you. And like Lisa said, we can't do it enough, but we will keep trying. And Father, I just want to pray safe passage for everybody tonight as they leave here. In Jesus' name, amen.